Their circuit starts with a jaw crusher, hopper feeder, hammer mill, and then they pump with a slurry pump onto one of these two primary tables, and then they take the cons off the primary table and send them back to the Mount Baker Mining shaker table as a finishing table. Off the primary table, comes out the end here into this slurry pump, and then pumps over into the Mount Baker mining table, and they're using this strictly as a finishing table. All of the gang, the waste, which actually in this case they tell me is lava rock, all the lava rock has been removed by the primary table, and they're using this as a finishing table. And so, most of the heavies, which I don't believe are sulfide, are coming up about halfway up the ramp and into number three. Some of the heavier, dense material is coming up the long grooves onto the cleaning plane. And then, every once in a while, you see a piece of gold come over. And they don't have a real high flow of gold, but many of the pieces are fairly good size. there's the tailings pile that they've got. It's probably 10 foot tall, and end to end is probably 30 foot long. Comes out of this steel settling basin here. The sand screw augers it up, dumps it in, and they clean it out with the backhoe. These are the jaw plates in this 8x12. And this is after about 150 tons. And what this tells me is the material they're running is really quite soft. It may be quite abrasive, but it's soft and it doesn't take much for the jaw crusher to pulverize it. The corrugations are still very prominent. There's very little wear on the jaws. The stationary jaw has a few spots where there's some erosion starting on the peak of the corrugations, but the swing jaw, boy, from here just looks very much intact. So everything looks good up here. These are hammers that came out of the hammer mill after about 100 tons of ore had been run. Some of these are clearly still usable. But it was interesting because I believe these hammers were probably in the middle. These two were closer to the edges, and these two were on the edges. And I say that because both the end and the face of these last two are worn, which is characteristic of the hammers on the outside next to the hammer mill hood housing.
These are the cathodes right here. So what will happen is each one of these will carry up to 30 pounds maximum of gold. So what happens is your pregnant leach is in this container here. It gets pumped up and then shot through and injected into the electrowinning tank. The rectifier is what gives the charge to these plates. It gives the positive charge for the negative ions that are in that leach solution. So it goes from a negative, hits the plate, becomes a positive, the gold ion bonds, and from there becomes a semi-metallic gold until you actually smelt it.
And what are the cathodes, the material?
There's two different ones you can use. For a majority of my processes, these are kind of a copper, like a copper mesh.
So once the gold plate's on there, how do you get it off?
At that point, you take the cathode out, and then from there, dry it. And then at that point, you can either sell it to a refinery or refine it yourself and smelt it.